I'll immediately hand over to Violeta Luca from Microsoft Romania, who can tell you a little bit, Aris, about their experience in operating something like a tech hub. So, Violeta, it's on to you.
Thank you very much, Matthew. Hello, everyone. I'm really thrilled to be here today. I will be covering today three themes: a highlight about Microsoft Romania operations in Romania and our learnings. Then I will segue towards digital transformation in Peru and see it developing in Romania, but also in the region. And then I will be closing with a couple of remarks on AI. So Microsoft is having 25 years experience presence in Romania. We are the second largest hub of Microsoft in Europe after Ireland. More than 1,500 people are working for us. We were blessed and honored and in the same time felt responsible to find here more very talented people with growth mindset. We are able to provide from Romania comprehensive services in support engineering up to software development with recent team in Iași. We are present in Bucharest, Iași and Timișoara. And what we learned is that Romania, it's really a hot digital hotspot for us. This is why we grew our site here and our presence, and we also have a very strong perspective to further grow our team and our footprint in the country. Definitely, we all lived challenging times, and Microsoft being a digital first responder, we were having the privilege to support various stakeholders in the market since March onwards. And I must say that I have lived really exciting times to with my team and with my partners, working with our customers from both private and public sector, first of all, to provide the business continuity and be able to have crisis response, and then working with our customers and partners to really transform the business models, to reimagine the way we do business, to find answers to the current challenges. Definitely, there is a strong case for digital transformation today, and our companies really need to empower employees to foster a new culture of hybrid work, to engage customers in new ways, and really, tech intensity, in our view, is the key to business resilience as well as to the transformation of it. And what I mean by that, so tech intensity revolves around how an organization adopts the latest technology and integrates it into the company, into the organization, how it builds its own unique digital capability and the trust factor. So it's really, really important to look at technology like a mean to an end, not as a destiny itself. Looking at what we accomplished in the market, I would mention one of the most intense moments in March and beginning of April when we have worked with Regina Maria, one of the leading healthcare provider in Romania, to really put the base of telemedicine. In less than 10 days, we were able to, together with our partners and of course with the customer, to offer to the customers a solution to engage with the doctors. And also we supported not only Romanians living in Romania, but also Romanians living abroad. It was one of those projects in which we really, let's say, provided our impact beyond the commercial purpose, but we really empowered the society itself to deal with the current challenges. I may say that after 6 months, we have more than 400,000 students and working, learning using Microsoft Teams, and more than 60,000 teachers using our technology to enable remote learning. And definitely, these challenging times are, let's say, drove a more accelerated digital transformation. And our CEO said it very well in the beginning of the crisis that in 2 months of pandemic, we had digital transformations as for 2 years. Looking further and referring to artificial intelligence and to responsibility to drive innovation, at Microsoft, we have identified a couple of directions to work in order to really be meaningful and have a sustainable impact. One, we are standing for closing the skills gap and enhancing employability. You may know that 3 months ago, we have launched together with GitHub and LinkedIn a very comprehensive learning and upskilling program for the world, aiming to skill 25 million people. For Romania, what I can say proudly is that after 3 months, we see 25,000 people already started learning using LinkedIn platform, GitHub, as well as Microsoft Learn. And this number, although it's small compared with 25 million, the total target, it's very meaningful in our area. And we are among the top three countries in terms of engagement of the people. And this is actually proving what I said in the beginning, that we have found in Romania very talented people willing to develop their professional career, willing to develop their capabilities. And this is, I think it's paramount going further, because without having a growth mindset, without really learning new skills, new capabilities, we won't be able to deal with the new reality. The second point, which we find very important when we think of artificial intelligence and digital transformation at large, is to really build coalitions for responsible innovation. Because indeed, technology is what we make of it. So it's really important to really drive positive disruption in the society for all key stakeholders, and to develop the regulatory environment, to develop the principles, the way of engaging in such a way not to provoke harm, but to drive positive impact. The third, it's really enabling digital transformation. And I have a very simple example in my mind. Before the crisis, nine out of 10 executives were really thinking of digital transformation and were having plans. But in some cases, probably the programs inside their companies were not really accelerated. Their main purpose were around customer experience and enable cost optimization and faster time to market. If I'm looking now after 6 months, I can see that better customer experience, outstanding customer experience, is one of the main motivators of executives to really digitize their companies, reinvent the business model, infuse AI in their application. But the second one is around risk management. And when I'm thinking about risk management, I really think about health and safety. I think about fraud prevention. I'm thinking about well-being of the employees. So I think with this in mind, we have tons of opportunity for Romania. Indeed, we have many things we are missing, but we have so many which we are in so much capital and upside which we have at hand. We have a great startup ecosystem. We have capable people. Technology is really melting the boundaries. And even if in some, let's say, areas we are behind, like my predecessor said, indeed we are. But it's a matter of purpose and it's a matter of motivation to really trigger an accelerated transformation and to catch up and to utilize the latest piece of technology to minimize the gaps and even to lead the way in some particular industries. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Violeta.